So the simplest form of predication supporting hardware will be a conditional move instruction. In the MIPS instruction set, for example, there is a move Z instruction that takes two sources and a destination register. And the way this works is that this instruction compares RT to zero, and if it is zero, then changes RD to become equal to RS, otherwise leaves RD alone. Note that there is no branch here anymore because this is a single instruction. MIPS also has a move N instruction that works exactly the same way, except it moves RS into RD only if RT is not zero. So we would implement our X equals, depending on condition, X1 or X2 by doing something like using comparisons or whatever to put the result of the condition into, let's say, R3, then R1 would be our whatever X1 expression we wanted to implement, R2 would be our X2, and then we would do move N X R1 R3, move Z X R2 R3, and this puts one of these two into X, depending on whether R3 was true or false, which means depending on the condition. The x86 instruction set has a whole set of so-called C-move instructions. So for example, it has C-move Z, C-move NZ, C-move greater than, etc., where the condition here is determined by the flags, and all of these instructions effectively implement the if the condition codes correspond to one of these conditions, depending on the instruction, then the destination register gets the value of the source register, otherwise the destination register is not modified. So you can see how we can implement similar behavior here, except maybe we don't even need to put the condition in a register, because probably we can just test the condition and then do like greater than, less than, and so on it.